students, in the last video we studied the female reproductive system. The menstrual cycle is an important phenomenon related to the female reproduction. In this video, let us understand what is this cycle, what are the phases of the cycle, and which are the hormones related to this cycle.
Reproduction in lower and higher animals. This video contains the textual diagrams from class 12 biology textbook of Maharashtra State Board. Also, all the websites mentioned here have been used as sources for the different images. Let us understand the menstrual cycle. Let us begin by understanding what is puberty or sexual maturity. Puberty is the age at which the reproductive system becomes functional. The gonads or sex organs start producing gametes and the secretion of sex hormone begins. The puberty starts in females by the age of 10 to 14 years of age, and it is a little late in case of males. It starts around 12 to 15 years of age. The puberty period in females is characterized by the development of secondary sexual characters. These are the characters by which a male and a female can be distinguished externally. Let's see what are the secondary sexual characters in females. These are a few characters: the development of breast, growth of hair in the pubic region and in the armpits, the broadening or widening of the pelvis or hip region, and a high-pitched voice. Another very important characteristic of the puberty is the onset of menstrual cycle, that is the beginning of menstrual cycle, which is known as menarche. The menstrual cycle continues in the female body up to an age of around 45 to 50 years and then it stops. This stopping of the menstrual cycle is known as menopause. The time period from menarche to menopause is the period when a woman can reproduce naturally, and this is known as the reproductive period or reproductive age of the woman. The menstrual cycle or the ovarian cycle is a series of cyclic changes occurring in the ovary and the uterus. The cycle is of approximately 28 days, though it may vary by a few days in every female. This cycle is a characteristic features of animals called primates. Primates include us, human beings, monkeys, apes, and some other animals. In the middle of each cycle, there is the release of the female gamete or the egg or ovum. The eggs are released alternately by the ovaries. That means if one ovary releases the egg in one cycle, then in the next cycle, the other ovary would be releasing the egg. The cycle is controlled by hormones called as the gonadotropins and the ovarian hormones. What are the gonadotropins? The gonadotropins are those hormones which are secreted by the anterior pituitary. These hormones are the follicle stimulating hormone and the luteinizing hormone. And the hormones secreted by the ovary are the estrogen and progesterone. The menstrual cycle can be divided into four phases: the menstrual phase, the follicular or proliferative phase, the ovulatory phase, and the luteal or secretory phase. The menstrual cycle is of approximately 28 days. The menstrual phase is the phase which begins from the first day of the cycle and continues up to the fourth or fifth day. From the fifth day to the 13th day is the follicular phase. The ovulation occurs on the 14th day of the cycle. Hence, this is the ovulatory phase. And from the 15th day to the 28th day is the luteal or secretory phase. Each phase is accompanied by changing hormonal levels, changes in the thickness of the endometrium in the uterus, and changes in the ovarian structures. Diagrammatically represented, it can be understood like this. The menstrual phase is from 1st to the 4th or 5th day. From the 5th day to the 13th day is the follicular or proliferative phase. The 14th day is the ovulation or ovulatory phase. And from the 15th day up to the 28th day is the luteal or the secretory phase. Let us understand the phases of the menstrual cycle. The first phase is the menstrual phase. The first day of the menstrual phase is considered as the beginning of a menstrual cycle. The menstrual phase begins when the egg released by the ovary does not get fertilized. In every phase, there are changes happening in the uterus and in the ovaries. Let us understand what are the changes in the uterus in the menstrual phase. Because of the decreased level of progesterone and estrogen hormones, the endometrium of the uterus breaks down because of the prostaglandin effect. Blood, tissue fluid, the unfertilized ovum are all discharged through the vagina. This loss of blood is known as menstruation or menses. Because of the breakdown of the endometrium, the lining of the endometrium now becomes very thin. What's happening in the ovary at the same time? Many primordial follicles start developing into primary follicles. This occurs under the effect of the FSH or the follicle stimulating hormone secreted by the anterior lobe of the pituitary gland. Let us look at the graphical representation of the menstrual phase. This phase occurs from the 1st to approximately 4th or 5th day of the cycle. Here you can see that the endometrial thickness is decreasing as the endometrium is broken down. The levels of estrogen and progesterone are low, and in the ovary, the development of follicles has begun from the primordial to primary follicle and gradually to the secondary follicle stage. This is under the effect of FSH or the follicle stimulating hormone. Now here, please understand the difference between the menstrual cycle and the menstrual phase. The menstrual phase is only a phase of the menstrual cycle. The cycle comprises of these four phases. The menstrual phase is the bleeding phase, which we commonly know as menses or periods. During this phase, some women may experience some physical discomfort like cramps or abdominal pain. This is caused because of the uterine contractions. The second phase of the menstrual cycle is the follicular or the proliferative phase. This phase begins from the 5th day and continues up to the 13th day of the cycle. What happens in the ovary? In the ovary, about 6 to 12 secondary follicles start developing under the effect of the follicle stimulating hormone. However, only one of the secondary follicle develops into the mature or the graafian follicle. The remaining follicles undergo atresia, that is, they are degenerated. As the follicles are developing, they release the female hormone estrogen. Under the effect of the estrogen, which is being released from the ovarian follicles, the endometrial lining now starts thickening again. The endometrium regenerates and the endometrial glands, the blood vessels, are again formed. The thickness of the endometrium which had reduced to around 1 mm in the menstrual phase now becomes 3 to 5 mm. As the endometrium is proliferating or regenerating in this phase is known as the proliferative phase. And as the follicles are developing in the ovary during this phase, it is also known as the follicular phase. Look at the graphical representation of this phase, the follicular or the proliferative phase from 5th to 13th day of the cycle. The endometrium is thickening again, so you can see a rise in the endometrial level. Then there is a rise in the estrogen level as estrogen is being secreted by the developing follicles. The follicles are developing from primary follicle stage to secondary to graafian follicle stage in the ovaries. And this is happening under the effect of the FSH or the follicle stimulating hormone. The third phase of the menstrual cycle is the shortest phase. This phase is the ovulatory phase. It occurs on the 14th day of the cycle. The process of ovulation takes place in this phase. What is meant by ovulation? The graafian follicle, which is the matured follicle, ruptures or breaks open and releases the secondary oocyte. The rupturing of the graafian follicle takes place due to a sudden increase in the levels of the luteinizing hormone. See, this is the 14th day, that is the ovulatory phase of the menstrual cycle. Here, we can see that the ovulation is taking place, that is the graafian follicle has ruptured and the secondary oocyte is released. And notice the levels of the LH. The LH has suddenly increased and it has reached a peak. And now let us come to the longest phase in the cycle, which is the luteal or the secretory phase. This phase begins from the 15th day and continues to the 28th day of the cycle. What happens in the ovaries? As the graafian follicle has ruptured and released the secondary oocyte in the previous phase, the remaining part of the graafian follicle converts itself into a yellow colored body, which is known as the corpus luteum. The word corpus luteum itself means yellow body. Corpus stands for body, luteum stands for yellow. The formation of corpus luteum occurs under the effect of the luteinizing hormone released by the anterior pituitary. Once the corpus luteum is formed, it starts secreting hormones like progesterone and small amounts of estrogen and inhibin. Under the effect of the hormones secreted by the corpus luteum, there is an increase in the thickness of the endometrium. There is a growth in endometrial glands, new blood vessels develop, and the endometrium is now 8 to 10 millimeter thick. The hormone progesterone helps in maintaining the thickness of the endometrium. The hormone inhibin stops further production of FSH. As FSH production is stopped, there will be no further follicular development in the ovaries. Let us look at the graphical representation of this phase. The luteal or the secretory phase is from the 15th to the 28th day of the cycle. There is an increase in thickness of the uterine endometrium. There is an increase in the progesterone levels as progesterone is being secreted by the corpus luteum. We see the formation of the corpus luteum in the ovaries and there is a reduction in the levels of FSH. This phase is called as the luteal phase because it involves the formation of corpus luteum. and it is also known as the secretory phase because of the various hormones secreted by the corpus luteum. But what happens further to the corpus luteum? This depends on whether the fertilization has taken place or not. As the secondary oocyte is released during the process of ovulation, it travels towards the uterus through the fallopian tubes. If during this course the fertilization takes place, then the corpus luteum is retained in the ovary for a period of 3 to 4 months. During this period, the corpus luteum continues the secretion of its hormones. The hormone HCG or human chorionic gonadotropin, which is released by the developing embryo, helps in maintaining the corpus luteum. But what if there is no fertilization? Then the corpus luteum can survive only up to 2 weeks. Then later it degenerates into a white scar tissue known as the corpus albicans. The word corpus albicans means a white body. Corpus stands for body and albicans comes from the word albino meaning white. If the fertilization has taken place, then the menstrual cycle stops till the end of pregnancy. But if there is no fertilization taking place, then the next menstrual cycle begins again starting from the menstrual phase.
Well, that was the menstrual cycle. In the upcoming videos, we shall discuss a few more concepts related to the human reproduction. Please share the videos and do subscribe to the channel. Thank you.